What's up, guys? John from LA, back with another video. Today we're going to talk about a very controversial subject. I'm going to get a lot of hate for this one. Best baseball movies of all time, the top 10 in order. Here we go. Coming in at number 10, Mr. Baseball with Tom Selleck and his mustache. He plays for the Yankees. He's struggling and he gets traded to the Dragons of Japan. So it's culture shock for him. He goes and experiences Japanese baseball and the cultural differences. The best part about this movie is him learning to adjust to the nuances of the game of baseball as they play it in the Japan professional leagues.
I'm sick and tired of this shit. Haven't you heard a word I've said? You're really pissing me off now.
Just take your base and get with the program.
You too, huh, Max?
You know the one thing I didn't miss about playing in the States? Is putting up with hot shots like you. Nah, I don't even have that anymore.
It was cool to see what it might be like for a major leaguer to transition from the Yankees to Japan's Dragons. Overall, it was a pretty fun movie. Good enough to make the top 10 list of all time. Okay, coming in at number 9. 8 Men Out. This was a great movie because it was mostly historically accurate. Also, I felt like the baseball gameplay was pretty good. These actors that they cast all looked like baseball players for the most part, which is important in a baseball movie because nothing worse than watching a baseball movie and seeing a guy throw or swing and you just know there is no way this guy is a professional baseball player. So that being said, one of the reasons I liked 8 Men Out is when these guys are working and they're fielding ground balls in the infield and they're turning two and they're doing all that stuff, they look like baseball players. Coming in at number 8, is it a baseball movie? I don't know. I'm going to say yes. Just kind of like, is Die Hard a Christmas movie? I'm going to say yes, it is. Coming in at number 8, Brewster's Millions with Richard Pryor and John Candy. Love this movie. It's hilarious. Baseball is not the main storyline of Brewster's Millions, but the main character is a professional baseball player. He's a professional minor leaguer that when he makes his money, one of the things he does to spend it is book an exhibition game with the Yankees. This movie is great. It's really cool watching Richard Pryor pitch to John Candy inside the hotel.
Come on, settle down, will you? Throw your arm out.
God damn it, she's gonna be real mad when she finds out what's going on.
Will you forget about Angela? She's a bad investment. Now, Eugenie's helping me out with my investments. You know, precious metals, some rare coins, some old stamps, stuff like that. He says it's a ledge against inflation.
It's pretty obviously stunt doubles, but they did a great job there. Loved Brewster's Millions. Great movie overall. Coming in at number 7, we're going to go with 42, starring Chadwick Boseman and Harrison Ford. Obviously, I'm a Dodger fan, so got to give that some love. Jackie Robinson, of course, the guy is incredible. His story needs to be told, and it was told very well in this movie. Another thing I loved about 42, like with 8 Men Out, is the historical accuracy. A lot of the things that happened to Jackie Robinson as shown on screen happened to him in real life. They didn't hide it. They didn't make it Hollywood. They showed what really was going on at that time and what was happening to this guy. Also, the baseball gameplay in this movie was pretty good. Chadwick Boseman, he was never a baseball player, but he's an athlete, obviously, and I heard he went through some really rigorous training to make him pull off being able to play a baseball player. Like the scenes when he's taking an infield at first base, and he's diving for those balls, that all looked great. Also, those scenes where he's batting and some of those fastballs are coming in high and tight, those fastballs are zipping in there, the sound that it makes, the pop on the catcher's glove, all pretty realistic. Great baseball movie. Number 6, we're going with Kevin Costner in Field of Dreams. Of course, Kevin Costner has to be on a best all-time baseball movie list. Also, James Earl Jones did great in this movie. Farmer in Iowa, here's a voice.
That voice just now, what was it?
We didn't hear anything.
Tells him to build the baseball field. He builds the baseball field. Shoeless Joe Jackson appears. Gives him an opportunity to meet his father and make amends with his father. It's a great movie. It's touching. Good story. Baseball in the cornfield. Really cool stuff. Coming in at number 5, Bull Durham. Another Kevin Costner movie. This could maybe even be higher on the list, but I'm going to give it the number 5 spot. Tim Robbins did excellent in Bull Durham. He's arguably the highlight of this movie.
I want to bring the heater to announce my presence with authority.
To announce your what?
Announce my presence with authority.
It was great seeing the struggles of minor league baseball players, especially an older baseball player trying to hang on to the game, clinging to the minor leagues, and watching him mentor a younger player. So, Bull Durham, of course, classic must-see baseball movie. Number 4, another one of my favorites, A League of Their Own. Tom Hanks, Madonna, Rosie O'Donnell. It's really entertaining. Tom Hanks is tons of laughs in this movie.
Mr. Dugan.
Mr. Dugan!
What is it, baby? Olga, what the hell is going on? Why have we stopped?
Lou quit.
Who is Lou?
The driver.
A car could have came by now.
Hey, come on, you girls. We got to get out.
What?
Get on a bus.
What did he say? Is that English?
By the way, I love you in The Wizard of Oz.
Hey, who's in my seat?
When he comes out and he first meets his team and he's shit-faced drunk and he takes like a two-minute piss. Of course, the famous lines in this movie, there's no crying in baseball.
There's no crying? There's no crying in baseball?
Why don't you leave her alone, Jimmy?
Oh, you zip it, Doris. Rogers Hornsby was my manager and he called me a talking pile of pig shit. And that was when my parents drove all the way down from Michigan to see me play the game. And did I cry?
No.
No! No! And you know why?
No.
Because there's no crying in baseball. There's no crying in baseball! No crying!
What's the matter, Jimmy?
What? She's crying, sir.
I didn't mean to do that.
Perhaps you chastised her too vehemently. Good rule of thumb. Treat each of these girls as you would treat your mother. Anyone ever tell you look like a penis with a little hat on?
Another story about a slice of baseball history that needed to be told. League of Their Own was great. They did a great job of talking about professional women's big league baseball. Okay, coming in at number three, Bad News Bears. Bad News Bears with Walter Matthau, Tatum O'Neal, Jackie Earle Haley. This movie is excellent. We've got the story of a washed up, drunken ex-pro who needs the money, so he takes on a gig managing a little league baseball team, and he ends up teaching his team not just about baseball, but about life and character.
Mr. Buttermaker, I don't know about you, but I want to win, so don't send me in.
Listen, Lupus, you didn't come into this life just to sit around on a dugout bench, did you? Or get your ass out there and do the best you can.
There's a lot of touching moments in this movie with all these little characters like Timmy Lupus. He's the worst player on the team. He doesn't want to embarrass himself or embarrass the team, but he ends up making that huge catch at the end and he becomes a hero. Also, the other character, I forgot his name, but the kid whose inspiration is Hank Aaron, and Walter Matthau goes and talks to him in the tree after he makes a few errors. He makes up a story about Hank Aaron having a terrible game as a little leaguer and committing a bunch of errors, and if only Hank Aaron had quit, history would have been totally different. And he inspires this kid to get out of the tree, put the uniform back on, and give baseball another chance. Great movie, full of great moments. This movie is iconic. It's legendary. Bad News Bears, that's a must-see top baseball movie. Coming in at number two, classic 80s baseball movie, Major League. We got Charlie Sheen. We got Wesley Snipes. We got the dude from the insurance commercials who played Pedro Serrano. We got the old pitcher with the knuckleball, with the Vaseline spitball.
What's that shit on your chest?
Crisco, Bardol, Vagisil.
Willie Mays Hayes character. The home run that's too high to go out. Too high, too high. Calling the home run shot and then going for the bunt at the end during the playoffs. Joe Boo, Ricky the Wild Thing Vaughn. Now, he doesn't have a 100-mile-an-hour fastball in real life, but the guy obviously could play baseball. Probably was throwing about 80, 85, which is pretty good. The reason Charlie Sheen looked like a baseball player is because he was one in real life. A lot of classic, iconic moments in this movie. Major League coming in at number two.
Let's cut through the crap, Vaughn. I only got one thing to say to you. Strike this motherfucker out.
And coming in at number one, it's not even close as far as I'm concerned. This movie is up here and every other baseball movie is down here. It's The Natural with Robert Redford. The incredible story of Roy Hobbs. This movie, start to finish, is absolutely magical. I mean, the kid losing his father under the tree, getting struck by lightning, making his bat out of the wood from the tree, carving the lightning bolt in the bat, going on a journey from being a top prospect as a kid, drafted to go to the major leagues. He meets tragedy along the way. He gets seduced and shot and almost killed by a Black Widow serial killer. This completely derails his career, takes him off the course from being a major leaguer. But he comes back when he's pushing 40 or when he is 40 years old and comes back not as a pitcher, but as a hitter and as the greatest hitter maybe anyone has ever seen.
down on him.
Try this one, Grandpa. Let me see that bat.
Not bad, kid.
Where'd you get this?
I made it myself from a tree near home.
Wonder Boy.
Take it out.
Put that on there? What does it mean?
I made it a long time ago when I was a kid. I wanted it to be a very special bat.
The scene where he gets his first major league at bat, lightning strikes, and he literally knocks the cover off the ball. This movie has the best ending of any baseball movie. It's just absolutely magical. It's perfect. Fun fact about this ending, there's a book, The Natural, which ended differently. In the book, he strikes out. In the movie, it's a whole lot different. We get the moonshot home run right into the lights. The only beef I have with the movie The Natural is casting Robert Redford to play himself as a teenager that's getting drafted, and then he plays himself also as an aging baseball player. They didn't do a whole lot of changing up his look with makeup or with CGI, so it's basically the same guy that we're supposed to believe is 16 that's also 40. That might not have been awesome, but besides that, this movie's fantastic. Roy Hobbs, he was the man, and The Natural is by far the best baseball movie of all time. Okay, that's it for today's video. Visit johnfromla.com. Like, subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching. Catch you at the next one.